Let's jump right into aggregated events measurement. With iOS 14, you must do this in order for things to track properly. If you don't set it up correctly, you could have 100 purchases come in and have it show 0 purchases. In order to complete this tutorial, you do need to have installed a pixel and have set up events. If you haven't done this in the pinned comment, I'll have the exact tutorials for how to do that, then come right back here. Start by going to business.facebook.com. Make sure you have the right business manager. Go to All Tools and then Events Manager. So we are going to go down to aggregated event measurement right here. And then we'll do configure web events. So we'll do manage events. Unfortunately, it can take up to 72 hours for these changes to take effect, and it can pause your campaigns that are using these events with your pixel. That's unfortunate, but try to plan accordingly. We're gonna add the events, and you can see that we can have up to 8. Although if you're doing purchases and you turn on value optimization, which I highly recommend, that will use up 4 of your slots, so keep that in mind. So we'll add event and choose the correct pixel. And it's ideal if you've actually received that event in the last 28 days, so you may want to actually go to the website yourself and become a lead or make a purchase. That makes it easier, but you can still select things that have not occurred in the last 28 days. So I'm gonna do purchase. Now, normally if you're generating sales, if you meet these criteria, which is you've generated 30 optimized purchases and have 2 different values, so people spending different amounts of money, I highly recommend that you turn on this value optimization. Turning this on will mean that Facebook can see who's making bigger purchases, and it can get better at targeting, saying, hey, these people we showed it to made huge purchases, let's find more people just like that. This next part's crucially important because you have to set the exact priority, and Facebook is only going to track your very top priority. So before, it would track things like this, where if someone viewed content, added to cart, did a purchase, they'd show up on all of them. Well, now it would only show up on your top priority. So if we made the huge mistake of putting view content at the top, we would show probably 0 for everything else because you're saying this is my top priority, only show results for this. And since it's the top priority, they won't show up under any of these other things. Whereas if purchase is at the top and view content is at the very bottom, now if people only view content, it'll track for that. But if they submit an application, it'll track for that all the way up. So you're actually tracking for purchases. I obviously always do purchase, then I'll do either add to cart or initiate checkout. And then if you're doing lead capture, that's important as well. View content is definitely good to have in there. And the other one will just depend a little bit on, you know, what you're trying to optimize for and what's important for your business. Just make sure you're not using up all the slots. Once I turn on value optimizations, when I'm running ads, these will all be filled. Now click on review. And you'll want to do yes, I confirm these changes, and then click apply. Here's a bonus tip. If you want things to track better in your ads, start building URL parameters. It can be as simple as just having the campaign source as Facebook. I'm actually working on a thing where you can see the results of every single ad and ad set, but that's a little more complex. Right now, you just do campaign source Facebook, click apply. I found this to be a little bit more accurate than the pixel right now and a useful data point. So when you go into, let's say, Google Analytics, you'll actually be able to see what purchases it's attributing to ads from Facebook. Check out my completely free checklist and playlist, which cover absolutely everything to do to get all set for iOS 14 and track better than anyone else on the platform. If this was helpful, let me know by liking and leaving a comment below.